The EUROSTEP is one of the most popular moves in the modern era, and you see a lot of today's stars implement this move into their offensive arsenals, with some of the most notable names being James Harden, Dwayne Wade, and Giannis Antetokounmpo, who have kind of turned into a signature move. Now, this move was invented by a super tough, crafty, left-handed six man who is an international legend. Oh, not this one. Yeah, I'm talking about Sarunas, Marciulionis, a Lithuanian basketball player who was actually one of the first international basketball players to actually be a parting piece for a team, as he was the sixth man for those super fun Run TMC Warriors back in the 90s. But his impact on the basketball world goes far beyond that, as he's one of the most influential international players in basketball history. But before we get too deep into the video, everyone watching, do me a solid and hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. If you enjoy basketball content and trying to help an up and coming content creator, your support will be much appreciated. Also, the question of the day is, would you rather have LaMelo Ball or a top three pick in the 2021 NBA draft? Leave your answer in the comment section below. With that all being said, drop the intro. Ramonis Sarunas Marciulionis was born on June 13, 1964 to parents Laimute and Juasis in Kaunas, Lithuania, which at the time was controlled by the SSR. He was actually the second son from his parents and got the name Sarunas because his mom had suffered a spinal injury while giving birth to his sister. But her determination in having a son led to the middle name Sarunas, invoking a legendary knight from Vicus Crave Mikivis, which ended up being a pretty good fitting name if I do say so myself. Now, the first sport that Sarunas fell in love with wasn't basketball, it was actually tennis. But Sarunas was actually a lot different from other kids playing tennis because he had a very unorthodox technique and he also had a strong bulky frame. So it just wasn't working out, and he actually ended up giving up the sport at the age of 13, being hospitalized from an incident involving a makeshift explosive. After that, he decided to pick up a different sport and end up choosing a very popular sport in the country, which was basketball. But he quickly fell in love with it, and him and his friends actually built their own outdoor basketball court on a parking lot. After leaving home, he ended up going to Vilnius State University of Vincas Kapuskis to start studying journalism and possibly try out for the Soviet junior national team. While studying journalism, Sarunas didn't play much basketball, but was still able to attract the scout from Stabia of the USSR Premier League. He played with the club from 1981 to 1989. He also played a limited role for the Soviet junior national team, winning a gold medal in the 1982 and a silver medal in the 1983 Olympics. But it would be a game in 1985 against Athletes in Action where Sarunas would place himself on the radar of NBA scouts after dropping 40 points on Donnie Nelson, who was the son of Warriors head coach Don Nelson. Sarunas was approached by Donnie and the two got acquainted, and Donnie ended up introducing Sarunas to his father as a potential player for the team to draft. His father listened but wasn't too optimistic because at the time it was pretty difficult to get basketball players from the Soviet Union because of the relationship with the United States. But the Warriors still ended up drafting Sarunas in the 6th round of the 1987 NBA draft with the 127th overall pick. But the pick was eventually voided because Atlanta, who had drafted Arvydas Sabonis the year prior, was also scouting Sarunas, who played alone Sabonis, and said that Sarunas was too old to be drafted. And they did this in an attempt to steal Sarunas from the Warriors. And the NBA did void the selection, but it wouldn't matter because at the time, Sarunas wasn't able to leave the Soviet Union. Anyway, it wouldn't be until 2 years later when Sarunas would be allowed to leave the Soviet Union and join the NBA. At this time, the Soviet Union was actually starting to lose control of Lithuania, who would actually declare independence about a year later. After leaving for the NBA, Sarunas was actually given a choice on where he wanted to sign. And even though he was being pursued by the Hawks, he chose to sign a 3-year, $3.9 million contract with the Golden State Warriors. Now, the perception of international players at the time can be summed up with the quote from Sarunas' teammate, Chris Mullin, where he said, "Here's this European guy, probably a spot-up shooter, let's get into him and be aggressive." See, the league at the time thought that international players were soft and passive on the basketball court, but Sarunas would change that perception real quick as he was one of the toughest and most aggressive players on the basketball court. In fact, he was so tough that even the GOAT himself, Michael Jordan, didn't want any smoke. And Chris Mullin can back that up as he once said, "I remember playing against the Bulls one night and Sarunas was shooting a free throw and Scottie Pippen and Michael Jordan kind of argued about who was going to guard them. They were like, man, this guy is crazy. He's going to run me over. Man, you take him." That quote right there shows you what kind of player Sarunas was, and players across the league took notice and respected it. Sarunas played 4 good years for the Warriors and was actually a runner-up for Sixth Man of the Year in 1992. That season, he was the third leading scorer on a 55-win Warriors team, averaging almost 19 points per game. Top an amazing year, that summer in the Olympics, he made Lithuania the second most popular team because he worked out a deal with the Grateful Dead, who sponsored them, and everyone was loving the tie-dye jerseys they were rocking in the tournament. So the only team that people loved more was the infamous Dream Team, or the famous Dream Team. Yeah, but if that wasn't already impressive enough, he helped lead Louisiana to a bronze medal, beating out the team that Lithuania was once controlled by, which was the Soviet Union. In the deciding game, Sarunas dropped 29 points along with 8 rebounds as a final way to stick to the Soviet Union. After such a great year in 1992, he followed that up, averaging about 18 points per game for the 1993 Warriors, as well as founded the Lithuania Basketball League and became their president. But unfortunately, the 1993 season will be his last productive season as an NBA player, as he would suffer a knee injury which caused him to miss the following season. After his basketball career, Sarunas stayed active further in the game of basketball internationally as he founded the North European Basketball League, which eventually would become part of the Baltic Basketball League, which actually is the same league that LaMelo Ball had his first stint overseas. For all of his contributions to the game of basketball, he was elected into the Basketball Hall of Fame in 2014, as well as the FIBA Hall of Fame in 2015. It's crazy that his name doesn't get brought up all that much in the basketball world, especially considering how much he did for the game. But it's good to know that he was respected enough to be a Hall of Famer. But on a different note, if you made it this far and liked the video, press that like button and subscribe for more basketball content, as I would like to see this channel grow and would like to have 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year. Also, don't forget to leave your answer for the question of the day, which was, would you rather have LaMelo Ball or a top 3 pick in the NBA draft? I'm not going to hold y'all any longer. Y'all have a great day and peace.